I'm going to show how to use audio replay and filtering in Testlab. First, check under Tools, Add-ins, and turn on Audio Replay and Filtering. If you have token licensing, this takes 36 tokens. I can then go to a time file or throughput file, right-click on one of the time histories, and there's an audio replay option. That option would not be there without the add-in on. After I pick it, you can see that the time history shows, and I have playback buttons. So I can listen to the data. Alternatively, I could open a front-back display, drag the time history into the display. I'm going to change that to real, which is good for time histories. And if I right-click on the data itself in the display, there's also an audio replay, which again would not be there without the add-in. And I can listen to the data. Another feature here is that there's two cursors, one on the left and one on the right in the display. I'm going to grab the one on the right, bring it closer to the one on the left, then move the one on the left. This area defines a range for the replay. So now if I click replay, it plays just that segment that I selected. In here, there is a segment entry where I could type and notice the cursor's update and then play back that segment. So I can define the segment by either moving the cursors or by typing in numbers here. It's helpful to always move the cursor on the right first and narrow the range, because if you move the cursor on the left, the right can scroll out of the picture and not be available for moving. Another feature here is when I hit playback, by default, it'll play through once. But if I go here, I can say repeat track. And now when I hit play, it repeatedly loops the segment that I'm playing. I could put another piece of data on top of this data in the display. So now I have two time recordings. And if I select both of them, I can do that by holding down the control key and clicking on them in the display or in the legend. I can right click, pick audio replay again. And this time the playlist area has two recordings. So now when I play, I can listen to one recording and the other. And I can switch instantly between the two recordings. When I switch, the no jump continues at the same timestamp when I click between the two recordings. If I pick reset jump, as I click, it'll always go back to the beginning of the recording I click on. If the data has RPM, maybe I'll narrow up what I'm listening to here. Another option is track jump. Here you can see these are at slightly different RPMs, and I say switch between them, they'll jump to the same RPM. If you watch closely as I click on this one, the cursor will jump back, so that it's at the exact same RPM. That could be helpful to compare back-to-back the same RPMs. While you're doing listening, you can also add filters, and you can have as many filters as you want, and you can define the frequencies for the filters here. And that includes things like order filters, for example. And now as I play, here I can hear a lot of higher frequency noise. As I apply the filters, I hear less. I can also take all the filters, if I hold down shift and highlight them all, and toggle them on and off at once. Sometimes, when you're recording with a SCADIS, data will be recorded in stereo. And that means that something like a binaural headset or a binaural head was used, and you have a right and left ear. So in this case, this symbol means that this is a stereo recording and there's a left and right ear. If I pick just one of these to play, it actually plays both, one on the right ear, one on the left ear. On the other hand, if I have separate recordings of right and left ear, so it was not recorded in stereo mode, I can select both of these, choose audio replay, and then with this stereo button, I can assign one of these channels to the left and one of these channels to the right, and then play back in stereo. Notice instead of two entries here, I have one, and that's because I'm going to listen to two channels as a stereo recording. So both are playing at the same time. I can listen to noise data, accelerometer data, any type of time waveform, and it'll auto scale and play back. The other thing under audio replay, though, is if I didn't want to auto scale, which is the default, I could type in a calibrated dB level for playback if I had calibrated my playback device. Thank you.